Turkey keeps on persecuting journalists. As many as 300 journalists and press members are currently behind bars or facing very high risks of incarceration anytime. Growing numbers of journalists are fleeing the AKP government's oppression on independent and critical media. Many of those who could make it abroad are facing serious charges at home and receiving death threats. Journalists in exile are now reporting from social media.
Merhaba, Ozguruz'un canlı yayınına hoş geldiniz. Bir gazeteci tutuklama haberiyle sizlerle birlikteyiz.
Can Dündar had to flee to Germany after he was charged with life imprisonment for treason due to his groundbreaking report on Turkish trucks carrying weapons to Syria. Resisting Turkish media blackout, he broadcasts on Periscope via a news portal, Ozguruz.
Önce suçu tanımlayacaksınız ki sonra suçluyu bıraksın. Ancak aşiret, ancak kabile hukuklarında insanlar suçlu ilan edilir. Ardından onlara suç icat edilir.
Ekrem Dumanlı was an editor-in-chief of Zaman, top-selling Turkish newspaper, before it was first taken over by the government and then shut down after the coup attempt in 2016. Dumanlı is now sharing his commentaries on YouTube.
Eğer insan hırsını, intikamını masum insanlardan almak için suç uyduruyor ve buna da devleti araç ediyorsa, bu dünyada görülebilecek en büyük zulümdür.
Tarık Toros, the former editor-in-chief of Kanalturk and Bugun TV, has joined the digital world from the UK, where he is on Periscope.
Son bir haftada şehit olanlara baktığında 7'yi 8'i buluyor. Günde ortalama bir şehit veya bazı günler iki şehit gibi. Başka ajanslara baktığınızda, bölgeden başka kaynaklara baktığınızda rakam 2-3 katına çıkıyor.
Being abroad does not save these journalists in exile from being the targets of the Turkish media and institutions funded by the Turkish government. Ekrem Dumanlı and Adem Yavuz Arslan are among those who are constantly being threatened and secretly videotaped. The government blocks access to social media accounts of the journalists in exile, trying to cut off all their ties with their followers in Turkey. Cemal Irshak was another journalist who had moved to Europe due to charges brought to him while still having treatment for his terminal cancer. "I want to die in my country," he had requested from the Turkish government. His request was rejected and he drew his last breath away from home.